Scene from a quarantine day two. This is gonna be so great. I can read all day. All day. And I can sit in my room and no one's gonna say, "Why don't you go out? Why don't you see your friends? You need to have more friends." Huh. Joke's on you. Who's going to survive for weeks on their own without seeing any of their so-called friends? Me. Who could survive for weeks on their own without talking to anyone? Me again. I wish I could quarantine for the rest of my life. This is gonna be easy. Scene from a quarantine day eight. Day eight. So things are fine, you know? It's one thing to say it's going to be easy to stay in the house when you have the choice to stay in the house. But it's another when you can't. Remember when you could go somewhere if you wanted to? It's a different kettle of baloney when you can't. I actually don't enjoy reading all day. A peculiar concept. We say it, but until you've actually sat and stared at the same page for hours and hours and hours. And I've done things, don't get me wrong. I've started a clothing donation pile and I've organized the posters on my walls. I alphabetized all my books. Rearranged everything. In my spare time, of course, in my spare time. But what am I gonna do tomorrow? Scene from a quarantine. Day 749 or 13. The situation is dire. My parents have retreated into separate areas of the house because of the "my meeting is more important than your meeting" clash of 10 a.m., which is followed by the "why are you wasting toilet paper?" meeting. 8 a.m., which is followed by the 7:56 a.m. "That wasn't 20 seconds" exchange. "Please send help."
I miss you so much.
Aw, not as much as I miss you.
I miss you more. Can you believe it? Quarantine.
If only they waited one more day for that stupid stay-at-home order. We could have been married.
And together.
Oh, the rotten luck. Well, still, we're healthy and well, and this is for the best.
We're healthy and well, this is for the best.
Did you get my present? I sent a messenger to your door.
Yes, I got it. Aren't we lucky? These messengers are considered essential services. Did you get my present?
I did, and I disinfected it thoroughly.
You didn't have to do that. I'm not sick.
You never know.
I do know.
You could be asymptomatic. You could have touched something.
I'm not sick.
You're pretty absent-minded. You could have touched something without realizing it.
Is that right?
You sound kind of testy, you know that?
That's because I am. Still, we're healthy and well, and this is for the best.
We're healthy and well, and this is for the best. You didn't have to get me anything.
I wanted to. You are the very first boy I've ever bought a present for. I hardly knew what I was doing. Nobody teaches you how to buy presents. For the very first boy you've ever bought a present for, especially when you're not supposed to think about boys at all. You're just supposed to be happy for the one your parents throw you at. Nurse taught me a lot of things. But present shopping wasn't one of them.
You did fine. I'll go so far to say you did perfect.
Perfect? That's a lot of pressure. This present has to be right. This present is representation of our relationship. If I got the wrong gift, that means my feelings are false.
No. I know your feelings are true because I can feel them all the way from your room to mine.
Oh, Romeo. Are you happy with the present you bought?
Totally. I got you the absolute best because I am an awesome gift giver, if I do say so myself.
Sounds like you do.
It was a little tricky because we've been dating one day, but I think I did pretty good. I'm not worried at all.
Oh, God. Oh, good.
Shall I open yours? Ooh, nice wrapping. Love the paper. We have to save that. Whoa, so much tape. Next time, I'll show you how to only use 3 pieces. You'd be surprised how little you need to use. It's incredibly satisfying to use 3 teeny tiny pieces to wrap something so big like a tennis racket, which isn't easy to wrap at all. And
just open it. Open it. Open it, please.
Oh.
You hate it?
No, of course not.
They're socks.
I can see that.
You talked about always having cold feet. Oh, I screwed everything up.
Relax, it was your first time. I've had more practice. Open mine. Aren't you going to admire the wrapping?
Nice wrapping.
I only used 3 pieces of tape.
Oh, a hairbrush. You gave me a hairbrush.
This hairbrush is specifically designed to get the tangles out of your type of hair with the least amount of breakage. It has a non-slip ergonomic handle with a balanced load distribution so that your wrist will always be at the exact right angle. A work of art and a work of science. It's beautiful. I had it engraved with your family crest.
Yes, you did. Can I ask a question? I want to clarify something.
You want to learn? I'm touched.
Because you're so much better at gifts. Your hairbrush is better than socks.
It has your family crest on it.
Everything I own has my family crest.
That is a good present. Sorry, this situation is tense for all of us. Still, we're healthy and well, and this is for the best.
The socks are way better.
How dare you?
100 lambs died to get the wool for those socks. The knitter wrapped because I made her redo the patterns 3 times. This is the mark of a fine present, chosen with love, so you can suck it up, Romeo Mancua.
I'm not sure I can wear socks lambs died for. I'll hear their death bleeding when I walk.
You're impossible.
You are.
You are.
You.
I need social distancing.
You're in your house. How much social distancing do you need?
Maybe the quarantine is going to show us we don't belong together.
Maybe we just shouldn't buy each other gifts anymore.
Maybe.
Yeah. But I do have an idea for your birthday.
What now?
Look, you don't understand. Things are different now. I really wish you hadn't come, Ms. Douglas. Look, I have to look after my brothers. There's literally nothing to talk about. We don't have a computer, and our internet barely works. So you can leave a packet of assignments if you want to. I won't be doing them. I have to look after my brothers. So have a good life as much as you can these days. There's nothing to, you don't, wait a minute, stop. Stop talking. Don't you get it? Nothing that you say matters. Everything that I worked for, it's gone. To graduate, work at the diner until the very last second, pack up my life and escape, get up out of here, it's all gone. I have no school, no job, and possibly no college. Can't leave even if I wanted to. So you better go. I have nowhere else after this. I'm gonna look after my brothers.
Your face. Don't touch your face. Don't do it.
You don't touch your face.
Oh, I won't. I don't want to.
Really?
Not at all.
Not at all. Really? No, not just a little bit. The itching isn't driving you crazy?
I won't let it.
Oh.
I understand the severity of our situation.
Well,
we must be diligent.
Right.
Don't you think so?
Sure, especially when I have friends like you to remind me.
These are unprecedented times. I feel I was made to rise to the occasion in these circumstances of difficulty and strife. Can't you feel the responsibility coursing through your veins to stand up and be in the moment more than you ever could as a human being?
Fine. I won't touch my face. I can't wait to be a better human being.
Good.
I don't want to. I do not. Nope. No. Ugh! I can't stand it! I've never realized how much I touch my face and scratch my nose and rub my eyes. I'm a walking disease factory. I'm a hotbed for infection. I am a power puff of plague.
All it takes is a little self-control. I'm surprised you can't find it within yourself to dig deep and wrestle with your weaknesses. We must do better, Rin. We must.
You just touched your face.
What?
You switched your cheek.
I did not.
You did. You did.
So what if I did? I washed my hands every 15 minutes. I wiped down every surface and doorknob on the hour. I am totally germ-free. I have everything under control.
You've got weaknesses, like the rest of us. Today is a good day. Don't touch your face. We must wrestle our weaknesses, or gently whip with them. Yeah.
Hello? Hello, who's there? I know you're there. I can hear you breathing. I'm out into the open.
Fine, fine, fine. Hello, hi.
You.
Surprise.
You're not welcome here. Get out.
Oh, come on now. Aren't you pleased to see me?
I'd be pleased to see the thing responsible for the global pandemic.
Oh, stop. You're going to make me blush. I'm green, not pink.
Why would I be pleased to see a walking disease inside of my home?
You know, disease is such an ugly word. You can call me Co, short for COVID-19.
I know what it's short for.
Not the name I would have chosen per se, but it does seem to be on everybody's lips these days, you know? You can just call me Co. I like that better.
I'm not calling you anything. We are not friends.
We could be. We could be best friends.
Stay where you are. Get back.
You're not being very nice. I'm a pretty fabulous friend. Is this how you treat someone who's been invited into your home?
I didn't invite you anywhere.
Alex, sweetheart. But you did.
I did not.
Last week, when you snuck out.
Shut up before they hear you.
Come on now. I'm not going to tell anybody. I'm your friend. I want you to raise your fist and feel you're being mistreated by this quarantine. Come on. I can't believe they don't trust us. We can totally do this social distancing thing or whatever. Resist and break free. Break all the rules you want. Push for things to be the way they were yesterday, last month, last year. Because when you do, when you sneak out and go to parties where there are lots of people to talk to and lots of things to touch, it's rather lovely. You're lovely.
But we were careful.
I'm sure you were.
We were, and no one there was sick. I promise.
I'm sure they weren't. At least, not visibly anyways.
I wanted to see my friends, you know, face to face. I just miss them.
And I appreciate that feeling. I really do. I have to thank you. Thank you so much. You make my job so much easier.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
You may not think much of me now, but we're going to become great friends in a lot of time together. Well, not a lot of time, but we will be great friends, the very best friends.
Oh, we're here. That was sudden.
Oh, no.
Why can't we choose our own groups?
Okay, we have 10 minutes to do the work, and then we'll be pulled back to the main page. The instructions are...
We're not actually working, right?
No, we're not.
What?
This class doesn't matter. She can't make us do a thing.
We get marks for showing up. We can talk about, like, whatever.
How surprising.
What shows are you watching?
Just like in class, you do the bare minimum, and I end up doing everything, losers.
Hey.
Excuse me, what did you say?
You heard me, but I'll say it again. Losers, both of you.
Hold on, because you wouldn't dare say that to my face.
Wouldn't I? Let's try. You're a waste of space.
Isn't this an overreaction? For watching to talk about Netflix?
Work or don't work, your slow descent into a useless life is none of my business.
What happened to you?
Just wait till we're at school. Just wait, because I'm gonna.
Oh, stop. You are not.
Are you telling me what to do?
Yes. Oh. What happened?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Did you lose someone? Is someone sick?
Is that the only thing that would make you care?
Why is it when some people find their voice? It is so annoying. You'll never talk like this. What happened? Your parents or something?
No, my parents are doctors.
Oh.
Where?
St. Joe's. Barely seen them in weeks. They can't keep up. They try. They don't say anything, but it's written all over their faces. I can't. There's a constant lump in my throat, and I feel.
The duck is at the door?
Yes, and knocking loudly.
That's rough.
So, you know, it's technically hopeless. Giving us all these assignments and pretending that school has a point anymore.
But I want it to have a point. I want something that feels normal. And besides, you acted this way before the world went kabloop.
Yeah, but like, things are different now. Everything is hopeless and now we're lost.
Sometimes I feel like it's hard to fight.
You have to. You have to fight because we are not lost. We're here. You're alive. You can't let this drag you under. Hope is stronger than hopelessness. Always has been. Always will. I know it doesn't feel like that right now, but this is temporary. You can't let go of hope.
That's a lot for someone who's just here for the marks.
I just want to talk. My parents have decided to handle this by working 18 hours a day in silence.
My mom isn't doing well either. She won't talk.
Well, I'm worried about my grandmother. She's alone right now.
Yeah, so maybe we can talk about movies or food or music?
Something normal.
Please.
Well, y'all, I think eggplant, now that I think about it, it's a little slimy.
I hate eggplants too. My mom deep fries
them. It's really gross.
No, disgusting.
I'm against all vegetables. My mother makes smoothies and tries to pretend she didn't put vegetables in it.
Mine too.
Well, my grandmother doesn't even try to hide them. She just stares at me until my guilt can't take it anymore.
There's a sign for Miss D. Is that good?
It was. Thanks.
Ooh, look, guys. You can't stop me. I've made up my mind because I've thought about this for a long time. You see, what else do I have to do? This is my decision, and you'll have to respect it. So I'm going to do it, guys. I'm going to cut my hair. And whatever happens, I guess will happen because I'll have to live with it. Mm-hmm. Because I can't live with this. Bro, look at it. Look. This is driving me mental. Y'all know I'm right. I know some may feel for some reason that hairdressers are not an essential business. But guess what? It is essential that I have someone deal with this. But that brings us to the essential slash non-essential argument that no one is choosing us all right now. Nobody. School's up to me. I'm the one. I must raise a pair of scissors and face the consequences. You know? Because right now, some may feel this decision is not important. No doubt. COVID-19, you know, there are bigger issues that the world is dealing with right now. But, you know, good hair at this point has a place in this world. So I'm going to do it. Yep. I'm still going to cut my hair. So here I go. Don't try to stop me. Wish me luck.
Human is still here. Why is the human still here?
What? Huh? Brooke?
Why is the human still here?
Isn't it great? It's so great.
Useless. The human always goes during the day. And now they're not going anywhere. They haven't left the couch in 3 days.
Our human goes places? We go for walks. Isn't it great? It's so great.
I'm not talking about your useless meanderings. How am I supposed to properly reign with the human underfoot demanding snuggles? I don't have time to snuggle during the day. I must survey my domain. This is distributing my order. We have to find out why.
Why what?
Why the human is still here, Lucky.
Isn't it great? It's great.
Useless.
This is the best time of my life.
You think every time is the best time of your life? 5 minutes from now, I bet will be the best time of your life. We must return order, Lucky. We can't let this go on. Let me think.
Hey. Hey, Shadow. Shadow, I got something to tell you. It's important. It's really, 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 really.
What? What is it?
I human is here all the time. Isn't it great? I wonder why.
Useless. The human is always busy, always on the go. That was the strategy from the beginning. Keep the human busy so I can reign in peace. Something must have happened out there.
Oh, where?
Outside, you doofus!
Outside? That looks pretty much the same to me.
But it's not. It can't be, because nothing is the same. The human keeps looking at me and talking and expecting snuggles. Order has been lost. That is not normal.
Maybe things will never be normal.
What?
Not like we know them. Maybe this is going to change our lives forever. And we'll have to figure it out. And we will. And our human will. You know, they might want it a little bit, but they just roll up their sleeves and go on. You know, we always go on, Shadow.
Lucky, did you just speak deeply?
What? Huh?
Useless. Idiot.
Have you ever said something out loud, like in conversation, where you were trying to sound funny or, I don't know, controversial? Or you just wanted to sound, I don't know, hostile? For fun? Spiky. Spiky. Like a hedgehog, only cool. A cool hedgehog. Actually, did you know that baby hedgehogs are called hoglets? Isn't that so cute? Ah. Anyways, did you ever want to have an aura of chaos? Just for a second, have a hostile adventure? Just a short one. Have you ever wanted to be steeped in unrest, even though you're actually pretty quiet and enjoy reading a good book on a Sunday night? Doesn't everyone want that for a few seconds? And I did it for more than a few seconds. I can't wait. I can't wait till we have an apocalypse. The world is going to hell anyways. Better sooner than later. And when it happens, and I'm telling you, it'll happen. No one can tell you what you want to do. No one can tell you what you want to do when chaos takes over the land. When disorder is the law of the land. You know, people ask me to say that last bit in the halls. When disorder is the law of the land. Yeah. So here we are. Chaos. The world. You know, saying something and actually meaning it are two vastly different things, it turns out. I've discovered I'm rather fond of rules and order and going to school. I don't want a hostile adventure. And I feel like this is all my fault because I wished it so hard. I wanted it so bad. I really did. And I'm sorry. I take it back. I take it all back, okay?
Are we on?
Yeah, I can see and hear you.
Great. Famine, turn your mic on.
Oh, Lord. Y'all, this is going to take forever.
What are you in a rush for?
I'm monitoring the situation right now. There's a lot of moving parts. It's a scenario that needs constant attention.
Uh-huh.
Besides, maybe I have something else, you know? Maybe I have a date.
Do you?
No, but I could.
Okay.
I can end the world and date at the same time. You know, I'm a great multitasker. Thank you very much.
Turn your mic on.
Hello, can you hear me? Oh my gosh.
We got you.
Hey, family, this is the 21st century. How do you not know how to work a computer by now?
Why are we not meeting in person is the better question.
Death can't make it in person.
Mm-hmm. Death can't make it for 5 minutes. I was looking forward to brunch.
I mean, you could take 5 minutes to learn how to work a computer. Just saying.
Listen, if you're going to start on me, I'll go. I have better things to do.
What is everybody in a rush for?
Just because you're not front and center per usual.
Are you saying I'm jealous of a global pandemic?
I mean, if the shoe fits.
Ridiculous.
All I'm saying is someone is not getting Employee of the Year this year and somebody else is definitely going to get it.
Where is Beth?
I don't... In the waiting room, let me just click.
Yes, no, yes, maybe. I mean, if they're gonna push it.
Hey, Death.
No, absolutely not. Jennifer, tell them absolutely not. Did you send the report to my email? Thanks. Okay, bye. Hey, gang. Battle.
Awesome.
You have a secretary?
Correction. Administrative assistant.
Man, why don't I have a secretary or administrative assistant?
Speaking of, can we speed this along, please, Kendall?
I call to order the meeting of the Four Horsemen of the Apocalypse. I see your hand. Can we get through the call order first?
Just wonder why do I have to keep bringing this up? It's the 21st century.
We are aware.
We're not all men. That's the first thing. And for second, when's the last time any of us were on a horse?
It's the name of the organization. Take it up with some higher pay grade. Talk to HR. The agenda for this meeting is...
I didn't get any agenda.
I didn't either.
Did you send it to Jennifer? Hold on.
Yeah. My sweethearts aren't filling me up. I'm getting kind of hungry.
I didn't actually write an agenda. I didn't think we'd need it.
Well, I'd wish you had written one up.
I wish I had a VLT.
There's only one thing to talk about. It's the only thing anyone's been talking about.
I mean, you could have still taken 5 minutes. You're not really busy doing anything right now.
War is happening. War is always happening. Just because you're getting all the bounty points for some jacked up flu.
you're totally jealous, my friend.
I am not.
You don't see me getting all bent up out of shape because famine isn't getting bounty points.
Or fessed up. You're looking a little green there, soldier.
Can we get going? Death, pestilence, if you reports.
I'll go. Oh man, guys, I gotta go. I just got an alert. Beaches are open in Florida. I have Jenna shoot you a report.
My turn. I don't think I need to point it out, but I will. Things are going great. Better than great, actually. This pandemic is over the top amazing.
Okay, well, why don't you just shoot me your report, too? I'm going to go make a sandwich.
But you always want to hear war's reports. Fair, man. I deserve to be a part of this agenda right here. I deserve to be heard. I'm going to write all of you up for this. In triplicate. Don't care.
That was a waste of my time. Not that I have much to do right now. Maybe I can start a war in Iceland.
I am slowly going crazy. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Switch. Crazy going slowly am I. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Switch. My dad asks me how I am every day. He's involved. Always checking in. I say fine. Fine, Dad. Thanks for asking. Doing A-okay. It's easier to say fine than explain. I should be fine. I should be. I don't have a lot to be unfine about, other than quarantine. The virus killing people and the possible collapse of the economy. I should be fine, right? Everyone I know is healthy. My parents didn't lose their jobs. And there are more than enough rooms in the house for everybody to have all the personal space they need. I have my own laptop. The internet's great. See what I mean? I have everything to feel fine about. And productive? I should be productive right now. I could practice my guitar. And how many times have I said I wanted to be better at Spanish? Now's the time. Now's the perfect time for me to become the best version of myself. I'm not doing anything. And no, I'm not fine. I'm heavy. It takes forever to decide what to wear in the morning. Poor Dorian, you feel bad? Poor you living in your big house with everything you could possibly want. See what I mean? I can't tell anyone about this. How my arms feel like lead, how my feet are trapped in cement, and how the weight's pulling me down. I can't breathe or see daylight anymore. I haven't seen it for weeks. How do I tell that to my dad? Why do I feel so sad and empty when I have everything I could possibly want? Hello. Wow, love your house. Oh, those windows are amazing. They are doing great things with blinds these days. I mean, come on. Blinds were terrible back in the day.
Wait a minute. What do you think you're doing?
Inviting myself in, obviously. You didn't wear gloves or a mask when you went outside. That lady coughed and touched the door and whoops, I'm getting ahead of myself. Sorry, poor planning on my half. I'm Co, short for COVID-19. Not the name I would have chosen, but we do what we can.
I'm sorry, but you can't come in here.
Sure I can. I'm in right now. I'm on you. Did you know that? It's like we're best friends. That's how close we are. And it's only a matter of time before we really get to know each other.
But I haven't touched anything. I didn't touch my face.
Hey, it's only a matter of time.
Well, not if I wash my hands.
Why do you want to do that? I mean, come on.
It's like the first thing you do when you come in.
You know, that seems kind of obsessive, if you think about
it. You know, I could be your best friend, and you kind of interrupted me, so.
Not so fast, wait. Before you leave, let's chat about with the COVID. You don't need to wash those silly hands of yours right away.
But you're here, so I really do.
I was just kidding. I'm not really that bad. A joke.
Oh, millions would say otherwise, sweetie.
Well, I can't help it if I'm popular.
Go talk to some of those people then.
They don't count. I want to get to know you.
Prepare to be filled with disappointment.
All right.
Wash those hands of yours. See if I care.
Done.
Wait a minute. Selfie?
Oh, for sure. Wait, no. Oh, my goodness. No. I'm going to wash my hands, and I'm washing you up out of here immediately.
You'll be sorry. I have tons of awesome jokes and tons of interesting mm-hmm. stories. I'm a pretty fabulous friend.
Right, but you kill people.
That's just an unfortunate side effect. No biggie.
Mm-mm. Out. Now. Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday to you. It's nobody's birthday. I hate that song. Scene from a quarantine. Day. Who knows anymore? Wednesday. Thursday. Soup day. Who knew the days of the week would be the first to go? Canceled, just like everything else. I went for a walk to nowhere, really. I couldn't sit in my room anymore. But there was this girl on my street who was in my calculus class. We never talk, not in the same, you know, circles. And we've never talked before. But she came up to me today. Hi, how are you doing? Okay. I mean, some days I'm okay. Ups and downs. Me too. They canceled prom. They did? Yeah. Yes, they did. That sucks. I totally bought this cute dress. I mean, when's this gonna end? I don't know. No one does. Ugh, that totally sucks. Yeah. Yes, it does. That was it. Huh. Conversation. Who knew I enjoyed that? Well, the sun is shining at least. It still does that. I'm glad.